Hey guys, it's Bubbly. Welcome back to the channel. So happy you guys stopped in to hang out with me. It's always so much fun when you're here. Now, if you're brand new to the channel and this is your first time joining us, welcome. Come on in. Come on. Have a seat, sit down, get comfortable. And if you have a good time here today, then hit that subscribe button and tap the notification bell so you can be notified when I'm releasing brand new content. Now, you guys, this week has been a super jam-packed week of excitement for The Sims 4. So as we all know, we received a free update that had tons of new content for us to enjoy. Namely, the focus of this build is the terrain tools. And on top of that, we received a brand new expansion pack, Get Famous. So how many of you guys have already got the pack and are playing with it? Comment down below and let me know what your most favorite parts of the expansion pack are. So to date, at this moment, I have not had an opportunity to actually play with Get Famous. It's been a super crazy week for me, so I barely had time to jump into game and try out the terrain tools, which I was super excited about trying. So here we are. I am still waiting to dive in to Get Famous, you guys, and I probably won't have a chance to do that until maybe tomorrow. So I'm really hoping that I get to focus on Get Famous tomorrow. I also have some other videos that I need to edit, but anyway, who cares about that right now? Let's talk about this Get Famous pack. So I am really excited about checking out the brand new careers and these movie lots. I am super excited about checking that out and seeing what it actually looks like and putting one together for yourself. I cannot wait. Another thing that I am super excited about with this pack is that you now have the opportunity to set your own Sim's career. So no longer does your Sim have to be unemployed if they are a vet or if they paint but haven't joined the painter's career. Your Sim can now have a job or a career that you set yourself. So I'm excited to check that out and see how that works, what it means, what I need to do to get it set up. I'm super excited about that. So you guys, let me know what you're excited about. If you're already playing the game, let me know what you jumped into first. And if you haven't tried out the game yet, let me know what you're excited to try once you get your hands on it. So let's talk about this build for a little bit. So when I started this build, I really didn't have any intentions of actually building something that I was going to record and share with you guys. But after I was playing around with the terrain for a bit and a build started to come together, I was really liking how it was turning out. So I said, let me record this so I can share this with the Bubble fam, because, you know, they might enjoy it too. So as far as the terrain tools go, if you guys are familiar with terrain tools in The Sims 3, they were a bit tricky to work with. It was difficult to figure out how to manipulate the terrain properly, and it was kind of hard to determine what parts of the area were flat and what weren't, and how to kind of mesh all those pieces together. So I didn't really play with terrain too much in The Sims 3. I did build when I played Sims 3, but I didn't build and share content. So it was a bit of a different environment for me. I was just building for my own personal enjoyment, and I really wasn't that focused on it. I was more into gameplay at that point. So I didn't really spend a lot of time with terrain because I struggled with it in The Sims 3. So when The Sims 4 announced we were getting terrain, and I actually watched the live stream where they kind of surprised us with it at the very end, and And just seeing how they were manipulating the terrain, I was like, "Ooh, I can't wait. I'm so excited." And it looked different from how it behaved in The Sims 3. So I was excited about it. So I managed to eke out a bit of time this week to kind of squeeze in playing with the terrain. And so here is the result of it. So as far as manipulating the terrain, I found it relatively easy. It was a bit of a learning curve to figure out the controls and what things I needed to click and slide and all of that fancy dancy stuff to get it to behave the way I wanted it to. But once you take the couple of minutes to kind of figure out what the controls are and what they do, it was fairly simple. Now, though, there are plenty of tutorials out already explaining how to use terrain tools. I know Crystal Gamer released one recently. If you are familiar with her, she does a lot of tutorial videos. She's really good at explaining how to accomplish things when you're building. So if you need some help kind of figuring out how to use terrain or anything else for that matter, head over to her channel. I will have it linked down below because she's been really helpful for me, trying to figure out some things that I had challenges with, as far as roofing was concerned. So, and she's super, super nice, super sweet, and very knowledgeable and talented builder. So check her out if you guys have any questions or you're looking for some tutorials to follow. So when I started this build, initially I was going to make it like a park or an outdoor venue type. I think I was going for a wedding venue was the idea that I initially had in mind. So the very beginnings of this build, which I cut that piece out of the video, but it was mainly me manipulating the terrain to form like little mountains. And I really wasn't liking how that turned out as far as a community lot, so I kind of scrapped that idea. And I was really just messing around with the foundations. I wasn't trying to build a house. I was playing with the foundations because the foundation system in the game has changed as well. So now there is a slider that you can use when you click on the actual foundation of your build, where you can adjust the height of your foundation to different levels. And it goes up higher than it used to before the update. And you can now change the foundation height of separate structures to be at different levels. Unfortunately, you can't merge those two structures, so you can't build a true split level in the game at this point. But they did say that's something that they would like to bring to the game in the future. So that's something to look forward to. So I was just kind of playing around with the foundations. I built a couple of structures and was trying to see how can I fit these together to kind of fudge a split level if I wanted to. And then I kind of morphed into this kind of mountainside, woodsy, rustic-y type of cabin-y build, if you want to, give it a name. I don't know. It doesn't, I really wasn't going for any particular style, but it kind of evolved into like a mountainous, woodsy, cabiny home with a retro flair, is the best way that I can explain it. But I really love how it turned out. So I loved how I was able to manipulate the terrain around the build to make it look like it was built into a mountainside, which is kind of cool. Where I live, we have a lot of homes that are built on hillsides, or the base of like a mountain. So it was pretty cool to be able to create something that is similar to the environment that I live in. So it was a lot of fun. I was really happy with how it turned out. I put a little pond at the very bottom of the terrain to make it look like there's maybe like a river that's running right in front of the property, and it sits above it and it looks out over, I imagined, a mountainous a view with a valley in the center and a river kind of running around it. So it was pretty cool. The only thing that was a little bit odd when building this lot is everything else around it is flat. So there are no other lots that have terrain implemented in the game. So I would have to go in and rebuild every lot in the neighborhood for it to blend in better. That's the only thing that's just a little bit odd, is that if you do pick a lot and build with the terrain tools on it, it just kind of sticks out a bit from the rest of the neighborhood. But if you plan to change the whole neighborhood, it's not a big deal. I mean, it's not really a big deal anyway, but as far as how your game will look when you're looking at a neighborhood, it might be a little strange to have one mountainous, like this particular build looks like it's sitting on the side of a mountain, and then the build that's right next to it is completely flat. So, as far as your own personal gameplay, it's not really that big of a deal. And I can imagine that there will be some pretty cool save files that will come out that will have tons of lots that have terrain manipulation, so the world will just kind of flow and blend a bit better together than it does now with just one or two lots that have the terrain implemented. But anyway, you guys, I do have something that I've been dying to tell you, and I hope you guys are gonna be excited about it as well. So now that Get Famous has released and we're all excited about it and we've been waiting and waiting to get our hands on it, I was thinking it would be fun to do a giveaway. So maybe there's people out there that haven't had the opportunity to purchase Get Famous for whatever reason, and they really are wanting to play the game. I thought it would be a nice way to give back to you guys, and thank you once again for being here and being part of the family and being super supportive and cheering me on and leaving me super sweet comments, which means the world to me. Absolutely, I read every last one of your comments and I reply to every comment that I get, and I just want to thank each and every one of you for the support that you have given me over these past few months. We've grown quite a bit in the last couple of months, so I'm really thankful for all of my new Bubble Fam members and all of the Bubble Fam members that have been here since day one. You guys are amazing, and the best way that I can think to thank you right now is to do a giveaway and give back to, help you guys out and also say thank you for being here and being part of the family. So I will be releasing a video very soon to give you more details about the giveaway and how you can enter for your chance to win a copy of the Get Famous expansion pack. And I will be giving away two copies of the pack. So make sure you guys stay tuned for that video so you know how to enter, so you can get famous with your Sims as well if you don't already have the game. Now, to go along with that, you guys, once I announce this giveaway, it's gonna run probably for a couple of, maybe a week or two. It's not gonna be terribly long. And then I'm gonna do another giveaway in December closer to Christmas time. So make sure you guys are staying tuned and keeping up with me so you don't miss when that giveaway starts as well. I think for that giveaway, we will do a pack of your choice. So if you already have Get Famous, but you're missing another pack that you've been wanting, then you'll have the opportunity to choose what pack you would like to get. So all of that information will be coming out in the future, so make sure you guys stay tuned for that. And one of the best ways to keep track of what I'm doing is to make sure you're subscribed and have your notifications on so you don't miss the videos once they drop. And then also follow me on Twitter, because I'm always on Twitter. I post updates to everything that I'm doing on Twitter. You will probably get more information quicker from Twitter than from YouTube. So make sure you're following me on Twitter also if you want to be in the early squad to know what I'm doing and what's been going on or what's coming to the channel. So you guys, I really hope you enjoyed this video. I know we haven't really talked about this build a ton, but it is a very cute house. I really enjoyed how it turned out. It's a two bedroom home. I built it like a two master suite type of house. I imagine the family that lived in this home was maybe a brother and sister, best friends or cousins or something like that. And they're kind of artsy, very environmentally conscious, and they love the outdoors. So I just built this house with that kind of theme in mind, but it was kind of a loose theme because I really wasn't planning on doing a build. So anyway, you guys, thank you so much for joining me here today. I'm always so grateful when you stop in. And if you enjoyed this video, give me a thumbs up and make sure you guys are looking out for the announcement video for the giveaway. That will be up. Make sure you're subscribed and have your notifications turned on so you don't miss that announcement video. I am also working on a Get Famous Let's Play that will be releasing very soon. And also, you guys, I am planning to do a machinima. It'll be my first machinima. I'm super excited about it and nervous, so stay tuned for that. So thanks again for being here, you guys, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye, guys.